India has achieved the unique distinction of operationalizing two trade agreements this year. Earlier on May 1st, the country signed India-UAE Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement. On December 29, the India-Australia Economic Cooperation and Trade Agreement or ECTA came into effect. The Union Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal said that the agreement has been negotiated with the speed of Brett Lee and the perfection of Sachin Tendulkar. The minister has said that there is a lot of potential for exporting finished goods to Australia. Since they hardly manufacture anything, they are largely a raw material and intermediate producing country. In this case, India will get cheaper raw materials, which will not only make the country more competitive globally, but also enable it to serve Indian consumers better, providing more quality goods at more affordable prices. The India-Australia ECTA provides an institutional mechanism to encourage and improve trade between the two countries. The ECTA benefits both India and Australia in four ways. Number one, it covers almost all the tariff lines dealt by India and Australia. India will benefit from preferential market access provided by Australia on 100% of its tariff lines, including all the labor-intensive sectors of export interest to India, such as gems and jewelry, textiles, leather, footwear, furniture, food, etc. On the other hand, India will be offering preferential access to Australia on over 70% of its tariff lines, including lines of export interest to Australia, which are primarily raw materials and intermediaries such as coal, minerals, ore and wines. Number 2. It is estimated that an additional 10 lakh jobs would be created in India under this agreement. Third, over 1 lakh Indian students would benefit from post-study work visa ranging from 18 months to 4 years. Fourth, the agreement will also eliminate double taxation on IT services, which were making India less competitive and making it less profitable in the IT sector. ECTA is also likely to increase investment opportunities, promote exports, create significant additional employment, and facilitate strong bonding between the two countries. Australia is an important strategic partner of India since both nations are also part of the Quad grouping, Trilateral Supply Chain Initiative, and the Indo-Pacific Economic Forum. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned to PBNS for more updates.